Hi children, do you remember how many rhetorical questions are used in the first stanza? Good, three questions. And in the second stanza also we have three rhetorical questions. Let's see what the poet says in the last part of the third stanza. What change does the poet notice in the tone towards the end of the stanza? Right. We can see that the tone suddenly changes. It becomes aggressive now. In the concluding couplet, the poet says that the answer may move and change, but they do exist. It is in front of us, but we do not see it. The poet is optimistic here. He feels that people may pick them up. There seems to be a hope of liberty being established. Bob Dylan says, "The world is out there and everything is there to be seen for those who wish to look." Kavi ivide uddeshikkunnathu ella prashnangalkkumulla pariharam nammude chuttilum undu. Naam അത് കണ്ടെത്താൻ ശ്രമിക്കണം, അത് മനസ്സിലാക്കാൻ ശ്രമിക്കണം. അതിനുവേണ്ടി ഉള്ള ശ്രമം നമ്മൾ വിജയത്തിലേക്ക് എത്തിക്കും എന്നാണ്. മൈ ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, യു മസ്റ്റ് ഹാവ് നോട്ടഡ് ദാറ്റ് ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് ടു ലൈൻസ്, ദ ആൻസർ മൈ ഫ്രണ്ട് ഇസ് ബ്ലോയിങ് ഇൻ ദ വിൻഡ്, ദ ആൻസർ ഇസ് ബ്ലോയിങ് ഇൻ ദ വിൻഡ്. These two lines are repeated at the end of each stanza. Haven't you noticed that? And what do you call such kind of repetition? Yes, it is a refrain. What is a refrain? See here. റെഫ്രെയിൻ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ നമുക്കറിയാം, ചില കവിതകളായാലും ശരി, പാട്ടുകളിലായാലും ശരി, ചില വരികൾ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ചില ഫ്രേസസ് റിപ്പീറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് വരുന്ന കാണാം. ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് കോൾഡ് എ റെഫ്രെയിൻ.
Gently down the stream, merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream, merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream, merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream, merrily, 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 life is but a dream.
And why do we use a refrain? See, a refrain is used in poetry to lay emphasis and create rhythm. താളം ഉണ്ടാക്കാനും ചില കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഊന്നി പറയാനുമാണ് നമ്മൾ കവിതകളിൽ റെഫ്രെയിൻ ഉപയോഗിക്കുന്നത്. ടു മേക്ക് ദ ഐഡിയാസ് ഈസി ടു റിമെമ്പർ. യെസ് ചിൽഡ്രൻ, ആൻഡ് we use a refrain to draw the reader's attention. വായനക്കാരൻ്റെ ശ്രദ്ധ പിടിച്ചു പറ്റാനാണ്. And also for the effect of rhyming. Let's watch a video and identify the refrains used.
Pinky, can you give me an example for a refrain?
Oh, sure. They are all gone away. The house is shut and still. There is nothing more to say. Through broken walls and gray, the winds blow bleak and shrill. They are all gone away. Nor is there one today to speak them good or ill. There is nothing more to say.
Oh, I understand. I know a nursery rhyme with refrain. Five little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell down and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed. Four little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell down and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed.
We know the refrains may change the tone of the song or the poem written. It is for that particular effect that refrains are sometimes used. Okay, children, look at this. In column A, you can see some words from the third stanza of the song. The words look up, sky, ears, people cry, ducks. And we have seen that all these words stand for something else. They are images and they symbolize something else. In column B, you write down what each word or expression stands for. Don't you like to check your answer? See here. Is your answer correct? Very good. Congratulations. My dear children, do you like to visualize the poem? Think of the various scenes that the poet speaks of in the third stanza. Just close your eyes, think and visualize. Hope you got a very good picture of the stanza. Now, here are a few animation pictures. Look at them. Identify the words or expressions in the third stanza which are associated with these pictures. Hope you like this song. Which line in this stanza do you like most? Complement this line with anything you like. You can draw pictures, sketches, or anything. Send it to your teacher. Later, you can think of an e-magazine in which these pictures and images can be used. And what about the title of this song? Would you like to give another title? Give an alternate title to this song. Send the alternate title also to your teacher with these pictures. How is it? Do you like to do it? Very good. Children, now we are going to discuss some important points of this song. Here are some sentences given in jumbled order. They explain the ideas of the stanza 1, 2 and 3. What you have to do is arrange these sentences in the right order and then prepare the paraphrases of each stanza separately. Now, let's read these sentences. Look at the first one. The poet laments that people do not listen to the cries of the oppressed. The mountain is a symbol of ego, pride, domination, and oppression. Bob Dylan wonders how long it might take for the dove to reach the land of safety and peace. Next sentence, the rulers and the authorities do not take measures to stop war. In course of time, any huge mountain may be washed to the sea. The poet wonders how long people must wait to see the sky of freedom. The sea represents the forces of protest. The poet demands that wars must be banned. Next sentence, the poet criticizes those who turn their heads and pretend not to see the injustice and denial of civil rights. The dove stands for freedom and peace. It is an anti-war song and an anti-political song. People have to suffer oppression and just exist if they are not free. The answers are everywhere, but can be obtained by only those who willingly make an attempt. The sky is a symbol of freedom. Cannonballs stand for wars. The poet suggests that if we just observe the world, we can understand the world much better. Wars usually bring about death and destruction. But the rulers and the authorities are not much concerned about it. The poet wants to say how the world is and what can be seen. Dear children, now arrange these sentences in the right order and you're going to prepare an appreciation of the poem. How do you do it? What are the points you should remember when you attempt an appreciation? See, now write answers to all these questions. And when you answer these questions, you will be able to write an appreciation based on these answers and also the points we discussed. Thank you. Dear children, what does the expression blowing in the wind mean? You had a discussion in the second episode. Find out the answer, write it here. And again, you should imply the relevance of this title. How this title is important in this particular context. Next question is, look, what is the poem about? What's the poem about? What's the theme of the poem? Yes, the poem is about war, freedom, and peace. It is a song against injustice, a song against oppression. And the poet reminds us that we should raise our hands, raise our voice against injustice and oppression. Now, look at the third question. What is the purpose of the poem? Here you should say why this song was written, what is the motive behind this, and you should connect it with the historical relevance, how it is connected with the civil rights movement and also the Vietnam War. And now, look at the next question. How many stanzas are there? You know, there are three stanzas. What do you notice about the stanzas? All the stanzas have only rhetorical questions. How many rhetorical questions are there in each stanza? Yes, in each stanza we have three rhetorical questions and altogether 9 rhetorical questions and 1 refrain. Remember this, write them down here. Next one, what is common with all stanzas? We already had a discussion. All stanzas deal with injustice. And the poet has used rhetorical questions in all the stanzas. Next question, what are the poetic devices used? Give examples. Here, you should write what poetic devices are used. Alliteration is there. Refrain is used. And again, you know, symbols. Symbols are also used. So write about alliteration. Give examples to alliteration. And then point out the symbols used. And you can also speak about the relevance of refrains used in this song. And what is the next question? What are the imageries used? What do they stand for? We know the poem is full of imageries. In the first stanza, we have the imageries of road, the white dove, the sea, and cannonballs. Then find out the other images in the other stanzas. Write them down here. And then speak about the relevance of these images, how these images are meaningful and relevant in this song. You can also write about the symbols, what these images stand for. What's the next question? What is your interpretation? Here, you have to give your interpretation of this song. Interpretations may vary from person to person. You have to write what you could understand, what all these images stand for, what each line suggests. Apart from the points discussed here, probably you may think about something else. Try to universalize. Use your own ideas, your own experiences, your own thoughts, and add all these points here. And what is the next question? See? What is your impression about the poem? Here you can write whether you like the poem or not and why. Justify your answer. You will be writing about your impression. That means you have to say why this song is particularly interesting to you. What is the tone or mood of the poem overall? How is it developed? We had a discussion on the tone of the poem, and we could see that in each stanza, the tone varies. When it comes to the final stanza, the tone becomes aggressive. And why? What does the poet particularly use the aggressive tone in the final stanza? You should think about that and write down your answer here. What is the poet's attitude? Children, we know each poet has a particular attitude to express. What he means to express, what he means to suggest, in what way he approaches his piece of work. That is the attitude. The final question: what is the historical context? And in order to understand the historical context, you should know something about the background of the poet. You know that the poet lived in a period when the civil rights movement was in its prominence. Dear children, I'm quite sure that you're very confident now. You now know how to write an appreciation. Using all these points, you can write the appreciation and then send your appreciation to your teacher. Don't you love to write songs like this? I'm sure many of you are poets. There is a poet in every one of you. Shall we try? Look at this little poem. What is special about this poem? When you read the first letter of each line, you will get a word. What is that word? Right. Change. This is called an acrostic poem. Poems with the first letter of each line giving a word is called an acrostic poem. My dear children, please write an acrostic poem on any of the topics we discussed in this episode. Shall we sing the Malayalam version of the song Blowing in the Wind? It's a very beautiful song. Let us listen to that.
എത്ര എത്ര ദൂരം പല വഴികൾ താണ്ടണം മനുഷ്യനായി പരിണമിക്കുവാൻ. എത്ര എത്ര കടലുകൾ ചിറകടിച്ചു പാറണം പിറാവിനൊന്നു വിശ്രമിക്കുവാൻ. എത്രയോ ജീവിതം തകർത്തെറിഞ്ഞ ശേഷമേ തോക്കുകൾ നിശബ്ദമായിടും. എത്രയോ ജീവിതം തകർത്തെറിഞ്ഞ ശേഷമേ തോക്കുകൾ നിശബ്ദമായിടും. ഈ ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ കുത്തരങ്ങൾ കാറ്റിലീണമായി വരും കാതോർത്തു കേൾക്ക കൂട്ടരേ. ഈ ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ കുത്തരങ്ങൾ കാറ്റിലീണമായി വരും കാതോർത്തു കേൾക്ക കൂട്ടരേ. കടലിലേക്കു മൺതരിയായി പൂത്തെറിയും മുൻപേ അഹന്തയാർന്ന പർവ്വതമായി നീ. ചങ്ങലയാൽ പൂട്ടിയിട്ട അടിമകളായി എത്ര നാൾ മോചനം കൊതിച്ചതല്ലേ നാ.
അനീതികൾക്കു നേർക്കു കണ്ണടച്ചു കൊണ്ടു നീങ്ങുക മനുഷ്യരാം നമുക്കതാവുമോ?
ഈ ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ കുത്തരങ്ങൾ കാറ്റിലീണമായി വരും, കാതോർത്തു കേൾക്ക കൂട്ടരെ.
തലയുയർത്തി മനമുയർത്തി എത്ര നാൾ കാക്കണം സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യജ്വാല കാണുവാൻ? ആയിരം കാതുകൾ തുറന്നു വെക്ക നാമിനി പീഡിതന്റെ നിലവിളിക്കു നേരെ. കൺമുന്നിലായിരങ്ങൾ ചത്തൊടുങ്ങി വീഴണോ, നിങ്ങളൊന്നു കൺ തുറക്കുവാ,
നിങ്ങളൊന്നു കൺ തുറക്കുവാ. ഈ ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ കുത്തരങ്ങൾ കാറ്റിലീണമായി വരും, കാതോർത്തു കേൾക്ക കൂട്ടരെ. ഈ ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ കുത്തരങ്ങൾ കാറ്റിലീണമായി വരും, കാതോർത്തു കേൾക്ക കൂട്ടരെ, കാതോർത്തു കേൾക്ക കൂട്ടരെ.
How wonderful, beautiful poem, a beautiful song. Children, now it's time to leave. Stay safe, stay happy. Me, Mohanan from Kootuvaramba, bye.